Hey everybody, welcome to my Kung Lao Punishment Guide for Scorpion. This is simply going to cover the moves Kung Lao has that on block, Scorpion can either punish with a single move or punish with a combo. Now, I want to make something clear right off the bat just to avoid any confusion. This is not intended to be, you know, a 100% foolproof guide on punishing every single thing he has. This is strictly going to be the moves he has that are punishable. So I will plan on covering stuff like special links in a separate video. So for now, this is literally just the strings and moves he has are punishable when you block them. So bear that in mind. Now, I'm not going to go by... I will cover the frame data, but take that with a pinch of salt, because as you may know, quite a lot of the frame data in the game at the moment is incorrect, unfortunately. From what I could tell with Kung Lao, at least, it seemed pretty accurate. Looking at everything he has that, you know, on paper is punishable, is actually punishable by the moves. So that's something to bear in mind. And on the screen, you will be able to see Scorpion's moves that I've got listed as his kind of go-to punishers. So I will get into that now, starting with the first string on Kung Lao, which is going to be his back 1-2, and then 2+4. Oops. Helped if I actually recorded. That's this string right here. This string's listed as minus 12, so you can punish it with forward 3. Oops. Like that. Any random spikes, like my execution's not that bad. The PC version is in pretty bad shape, in my opinion. So there's a lot of stuff going on that I'm really not happy about, like the frame rate issues and stuff like that. But it shouldn't alter it too much. Now, one thing I do want to note, I'm not going to put on the auto block for this. I've already done all that before doing this to try and make this video short. So forward 3 does punish it, but you do have to be very quick to the party. You can't be late. If you are having trouble using forward 3 as a punisher, because he does have a couple of moves that forward 3 is your best punisher, and you can link forward 3 into spear or either EX teleport to get a combo. If you're having trouble with forward 3, then use the takedown. It's obviously going to be less damage, but it's 10 frames, so it's a lot faster. And it's just, you don't have to be as strict with the time. You can buffer it in a little bit. As you can see, you know, takedown comes out very, very fast. So if you're having trouble with forward 3 at first, I'd recommend using takedown. The next string for Kung Lao, putting back to block, is going to be his forward 1-4, which is this one right here, ends in the low. This one is, again, listed as minus 26, but you can punish it with Scorpion standing 2, which leads into his 2-1-4, so that one's full combo punishable. The next one on the list is going to be his back 2-2, which is the hat double overhead. Again, this one is punishable with standing 2. And again, if you're having trouble with standing 2, using that as a punish, then you can use 1-1-4. 1-1 is a slightly faster string than 2, so if you are having trouble with that, you can always use 1-1 until you get more comfortable with standing 2. The next string for Kung Lao is going to be his forward 2-1 down 1, which is this one right here. Now, because of the pushback, you do have to use forward 3 to punish this, like that. And again, if you're having trouble doing that, then just use takedown. You can kind of see how much faster takedown comes out than forward 3. Forward 3 does have a little bit of travel time, so forward 3 into spear, or, you know, forward 3 into EX teleport. If you are having trouble, then just use takedown. Okay, the next string is going to be his forward 2-3, which is this one right here, ends in a low. And that one, that was 43. Yeah, that one also is standing 2 punishable, so that's full combo punishable. His next one is going to be his forward 4. I'm simply just going down the list that I have here, guys. So, forward 4, which is this double overhead. Now, the one thing to note about this move is that when you go to punish this, make sure you are going for your punish as soon as that second kick is blocked. If you wait until he lands like that, I'll just show that real quick, because it is something that, you know, you do kind of need to bear in mind. If you go forward 4 like this, and then you wait for him to land, he can actually block your punish. So, yeah, make sure you're not late to the party with your punish. As soon as you see that second kick blocked, go for your punish. Again, use 1-1. This frame rate stuff's really annoying me. The next one on the list is going to be his forward 3, which is this move right here, his advancing mid-kick. This one is listed as minus 16, and it feels pretty accurate. You know, standing 2 is a pretty good punish for that. Again, that does take him into other strings, so, you know, bear that in mind. Moving on to his specials now, two of the most obvious ones, I guess, are his spins. Both of his spins are extremely negative. You can do, you know, pretty much any launcher you want When you block a spin, you can do forward three, standing two. You can actually even do forward four. That's how negative that move is. So, you know, something to bear in mind. The next one is going to be his dive kicks, both of which, again, extremely punishable. It doesn't really matter what height you block them at. I think they are listed in, you know, that minus 20 plus frames. Like, they are extremely negative, so it doesn't matter what height you can punish these. The next one's going to be his teleport 2. Oops. Which is the hat overhead out of his teleport. Doesn't matter. Again, this looks like it's a bit deceptive on range, but doesn't matter. You can punish it. You can punish that when you block it. You can even use 1-1. 1-1 has less range. It just looks like it's kind of, you know, staggers you back a bit further than it does. And the last one is going to be his hat. So any variation on the standard hat, that is, you can actually punish. So if, you know, for whatever reason, if a Kung Lao ends a string in hat, then 2-1. Get into a good punish. And as I said, I'm very aware that a Kung Lao is not just going to throw out a hat at the end of the string. This is simply just what is punishable and what isn't. So that pretty much does cover it for Kung Lao. One thing I did want to mention, you may notice in the hat trick variation, he does have some stuff that's listed as, you know, punishable on paper, but due to the actual calling back of the hat, you can't actually punish him. So I'll just go over that real quick. So you'll see how all these moves here are, you know, minus 40-something. You know, they're all extremely negative, right? But however, the actual calling back the hat, he's actually plus when you block it. So, you know, you can't actually punish him out of that. The one slight variation to that, however, is the EX hat in this variation. When you block that, you can actually interrupt that with a takedown. So, show that again. I just noticed I forgot to crouch. Yeah. That's kind of the one exemption to that. When it goes behind you, you can actually interrupt it with takedown. Like so. And you have quite a big window to do this. Yeah, like, that's kind of... Up until he crouches there, basically, is when he blocked my my takedown. So, yeah. That blocked it. That blocked it. That interrupts. So, you have a pretty big window to interrupt that. So, that pretty much covers it for Kung Lao. Hope this helps some people. As I said, I'll get into more kind of string-specific stuff into specials in another video. For now, this is simply just to cover the basics. So, hope this helps some people. Any comments or feedback or anything like that, doing these kind of videos is something new for me. So, you know, definitely not afraid to learn a thing or two. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.